Hola amigos, bienvenidos a JupiteriaWorld.com a nivel intermedio de español, the Spanish Intermediate Level. Hablemos español. On the lecture of today, you're going to learn more common expressions and now some idioms in Spanish. As you may know, idioms or idiomatic expressions are, as they say, phrases or expressions that have a figurative meaning. Generally, they don't mean exactly what the words of the phrase say, but native speakers usually use them because they recognize and identify the real meaning of the expression by itself. So let's start. Comencemos a conocer más de estas frases. Remember that if you get to know to these phrases, when you get to talk to someone, you can be considered even almost a native speaker, because these expressions and idioms make part of the language by itself. Let's start, amigos. Comencemos. Let's review a little bit from the previous video we worked on. Revisemos un poco. Voy a presentarte tres frases. I'm going to present you three phrases, and you have to complete them with the right expression, according to the expressions we started on the previous video, of course. Veamos. Completa las frases con la expresión correcta. Complete the phrases with the right expression. Veamos la primera frase. El señor de la tienda coquetea con las jóvenes. Es un the old man that said that works in the store likes to flirt with the young ladies. He's a ¿qué es? Es un príncipe azul, un sapo verde o un viejo verde. Ana arruinó el pastel de bodas. Ana ruined the wedding cake. She es una cara dura, metió la pata o les dio una mano. Y veamos la tercera frase. Para Elena, todo es siempre lindo y hermoso. For Elena, everything is always pretty beautiful. Ella es de sangre azul, lee la prensa rosa o ve la vida color de rosa. Let's see for the first phrase, which is the right answer. This old man that likes to flirt with young ladies. El señor de la tienda coquetea con las jóvenes. Es un viejo verde. Remember the expression. Viejo verde. For a man that has already a certain age and likes to go out and have a relation with a younger woman. Ana arruinó el pastel de bodas. Ella metió la pata. She made a huge mistake. Metió la pata. Para Elena, todo es siempre lindo y hermoso. Ella ve la vida color de rosa. She sees life in a pink color. For her, everything is nice. Everything is perfect and beautiful. In the first one, of course, Príncipe Azul is not correct because it's Prince Charming. And the letter B is a green frog. In the second one, cara dura, remember that is a person that has no respect sometimes for others because he or she can do something that is not correct without any regrets. And les dio una mano is not the right option because remember, dar una mano is give a hand to help. In the third one, este sangre azul makes reference to a person that makes part of a royal family. En leer la prensa rosa is to read the pink journals, the media. En prensa rosa is the media where you, remember, is the media where you find gossips and information about couples, celebrity couple. Veamos ahora estas nuevas expresiones de hoy. Let's see which are the expressions we're going to learn today. Algunos dichos y expresiones comunes en español son, and these expressions can also be called idiomatic expressions because as you will see, they don't mean exactly what the words reflect. You see. Let's read this paragraph. Leamos este párrafo para encontrar nuevas expresiones. Alfredo perdió su auto, su trabajo y su novia este mes. Alfredo lost his car, his job and his girlfriend this month. Definitivamente, él está muy salado. Esta situación hace que esté de malas todos los días. y no pegue un ojo por las noches. Ahora debe 2 meses de renta y si no los paga lo echarán de su departamento. Está entre la espada y la pared. As you can see, in blue, you have some expressions and idioms that are very common in Spanish. And let's see, according to the text, and you're going to find out what do they mean. Alfredo lost his car, his job, and his girlfriend this month. Definitely, he is very salty. This is the literal meaning of the literal translation. But the meaning, according to what you just read, what do you think? Does he have a lot of, does he have good luck or bad luck? Of course, estar muy salado is having bad, is to have bad luck. Está salado. Esta situación hace que esté de malas todos los días. This situation makes him being in a bad mood. Estar de malas. You have a bad mood every day. Estar de malas can also be used with buenas. Está de buenas o está de malas. You only say that. For example, Adriana está de buenas. And with this you mean that she's in a good mood, she's happy. But if you say, like this case, the case of Alfredo, está de malas todos los días, he's in a bad mood every day because of the situation, of course. This situation makes him not close an eye in the night, at night. Pegar un ojo. It can be like close an eye, but as the literal translation. But in Spanish, this means that you can't sleep. You can't get to sleep. No pegar un ojo. It's not to sleep because you're worried, generally because you're worried about something. Ahora debe 2 meses de renta. He has to pay 2 months for the rent. And if he doesn't pay it, y si no los paga, lo echarán de su departamento. He has to leave the apartment. So he's between the wall, between the sword and the wall. This is the literal translation, of course, of the expression. Estar entre la espada y la pared. Pero en verdad significa que estás atrapado. You're trapped between two decisions and between two options. And sometimes the two options are not very positive. Either you choose one of these options or the other one. They might be a little bit negative. They are not very positive. This is estar entre la espada y la pared. You're like trapped between two options that are not very very good for you. Otras expresiones muy comunes en español son estas. These are another expressions and idioms that are very common in Spanish. Buscar la quinta pata al gato. Looking for a fifth foot for the cat. Of course, this would be the literal translation, but in Spanish this means that that person is getting too complicated. If, for example, the problem can be very small, but if you continue looking for negative things on the problem, you're getting it bigger than it really is. That is to look for the fifth foot of the cat. Of course, the cats don't have one, but this person that gets complicated and worried for nothing may be adapted to this expression. Busca, no le busques la quinta pata al gato. Puede ser un ejemplo. Echar leña al fuego. To put more wood in the fire. This is the literal translation. But it can mean that when something is already controversial, or when someone is already angry and you say something that makes him or her feel angrier, of course this is to put more wood in the fire, to make it hotter, to make it bigger. Echar leña al fuego. Y tienes también la expresión ser la piedra en el zapato. Being the stone in your shoe is something that bothers you. that doesn't let you continue or get to do something. Por ejemplo, mi vecino es es la piedra en mi zapato. My neighbor is the stone in my shoe because he's always making parties and I can't get to have a nice life. Living next to him. Ser la piedra en el zapato, the stone in the shoe, is something, as I said before, that disturbs you, that is very, that doesn't let you continue. It bothers you, of course, as a real stone can do in your shoe. It bothers you. Veamos ahora algunos dichos y expresiones que son equivalentes en español y en inglés. In English and Spanish, you can find some expressions and idioms that are the same, they are equivalent. Let's see some of them. Por ejemplo, ese examen fue pan comido. Pan comido is the equivalent of the expression piece of cake in English. So now you know that pan comido en español es cuando algo es muy fácil, when something is very easy. Ese examen fue pan comido. That test was piece of cake. Pan comido. Eaten bread. Hablando del rey de Roma. Speaking of Rome's king. In Spanish, we use this. But in English, look what we use. Hablando del rey de Roma y mira quién llega. Speaking of Rome's king, and look who arrives. This would be the equivalent of speak of the devil. It means, as you use it in English, and it means that you're talking about the person, and suddenly that person arrives to the place to where you're reunited with someone. Speaking of the devil, hablando del rey de Roma. Juan tuvo una cucharada de su propia medicina. In English, it would be a taste of your own medicine. In this case, a taste of his own medicine. In Spanish, we use the spoon. He tastes a spoon of his own medicine. And of course, as you use it in English, in Spanish, it also means that that you received what you gave. If you did a bad action to a person, you got the same result for you, the same bad result for you. That is to taste your own, have a taste of your own medicine. Tener una cucharada de tu propia medicina. Olvida eso, no se puede llorar por la leche derramada. Este es el equivalente en inglés en español de cry over spilled milk. Llorar por la leche derramada. Y esto significa que no hay por qué llorar por cosas que ya pasaron. You know, you can't cry or regret things that have already happened. The milk is already spilled, so you can't cry. It is already there. You can't take it back to the bottle. No puedes regresar lo que ya pasó. Así que hay que continuar. You have to go to move. You have to move forward and continue, okay? Because you can't change things that already happened. No puedes cambiar lo que ya pasó. Tienes también, conócelo mejor y verás que no se puede juzgar un libro por su cubierta. No se puede juzgar un libro por su cubierta es el equivalente en español de you can't judge a book by its cover. Get to know him better and you will see that you can't judge a book by its cover. Esto quiere decir que no debes juzgar a alguien por su primera impresión o por su apariencia. Debes conocerla y así saber si es agradable. You can't judge a person because of the way he or she looks, because of his or her appearance. You have to get to know people and in that way you can make your own opinion about him or her. Hay más expresiones en español que tienen su equivalente en inglés. O al revés. Expresiones en inglés que tienen su equivalente en español. There are more expressions that have the equivalent form in Spanish. Por ejemplo, ese bolso le costó un ojo de la cara. Costar un ojo de la cara is the equivalent of cost an eye or cost an arm and an eye. And as it means in English, in Spanish it also means that it is very, very expensive. Ese bolso le costó un ojo de la cara. That purse cost her an eye of the face. Mm-hmm. Fue muy caro, expensive. Es un bolso muy caro. Por no haber aprovechado esa oportunidad, dicen que ella perdió el tren. Perdió el tren is the equivalent in Spanish of missed the boat because for not having taken advantage of that opportunity, they say that she lost the train. In Spanish we say missed the train. And in English, missed the boat. In both cases, in Spanish and English, this means that you lost. Maybe you let a good opportunity pass and didn't take advantage of it. Perder el tren. Juan se preocupa demasiado. Él ve una tormenta en un vaso de agua. O hace una tormenta en un vaso de agua. Juan worries a lot. He sees or he makes a storm in a glass of water. This, ver una tormenta en un vaso de una tormenta en un vaso de agua es el equivalente en español de a storm in a teacup. And they both mean the same. It means that maybe you can make a small problem bigger if you get to worry too much, if you get worried all the time. Juan worries a lot. Juan se preocupa demasiado. Ve una tormenta en un vaso de agua. To make a very small problem or complication bigger only because of your thoughts and your worries. Elisa es muy distraída. Siempre está en la luna. Estar en la luna es el equivalente en español de la frase have your head in the clouds. Este es el equivalente en inglés es in the clouds. In Spanish is in the moon. She is in the moon. But they both mean the same. This makes reference to a person that is very distracted, is always thinking about something else and not in the present moment he or she is. Elisa es muy distraída, siempre está en la luna. Y veamos una más. Voy a comprar esto y de paso compro la cena. Así mato dos pájaros de un solo tiro. I'm going to buy this and as I pass by, I buy dinner. In this way, I kill two birds with one shot. Matar dos pájaros de un solo tiro es el equivalente en español de la frase kill two birds with the same stone. In Spanish, we use shot, like with a gun. In English, we use stone, but they both mean the same. It means that that you can do two things you have to do in the same moment, and you take advantage of that very moment to finish both things, both tasks. Matar dos pájaros de un solo tiro. Well, my friends, these were the expressions of today. For the next video, we're going to work on connectors, which are very important in your written and for your written and speaking skills. I hope that you really enjoyed the video of today. Espero hayas disfrutado el video de hoy. Y bueno, nos vemos pronto. Gracias por vernos. Adiós.